Welcome back to another awesome video.
Today, we're going to look at this Radio Shack Electronic TV Scoreboard, which was available from 1979 to 1983. This is an action-packed video game system that attaches to your TV, and it has a light gun controller. Let me tell you the story about how I got it. Back in the mid-1980s, we had a program at our school called Bonus Bucks. You got bonus bucks for classroom rewards and extra reading, sort of like your accelerated reader program you have today. And you could redeem these bonus bucks in the bookstore at the school for mostly junk like erasers, pencils, and rulers. But on the top shelf, more points than any other item, was this video game system.
How do you get it? How did you get that bonus bucks?
Me and my four enterprising friends pooled our bonus bucks and got this thing. We even had some elaborate sharing schedule, but all these years later, I ended up with it. It's a video game system for two players. It hooks up to your TV. The game controllers are just plain old knobs. One of the controllers also has some game option switches above the player controls. Now, this is not a cartridge system like, you know,
Intellivision.
Yeah, or Atari. It just has six baked-in games. That's it. You select them with the dial at the top. Most of them are some variation of Pong. Very simple stuff. And two of the games out of the six games use a light gun controller, which plugs into this port called Pistol. What do you think of it?
Doesn't look like realistic games that I play these days.
No, it's definitely different. Yeah, it's not quite as good as even the games I was used to at your age. This system debuted in the 1979 Radio Shack catalog for $39.95, but by the time my friends and I acquired it in the mid-1980s, as you can see, it had been marked down several times. The lowest price I found on the box was $12.95. The technology and the games on the system were just not very good compared to what we were used to, as we'll see in a minute. In 1979 and 1980, they offered this system and a similar model without the light gun and only four games. From 1981 to 1983, they dropped the cheaper model, only offering this version. One interesting fact I noticed about all these ads, in every picture and on the back of the box, they have the controllers reversed. In other words, the actual game unit has the left player controller, which clips on the left side of the box, but in every picture, the left controller is placed on the right side. And speaking of controllers, this was not the first iteration of the Electronic TV Scoreboard. It had been tried earlier with different types of controllers. Four players, different types of guns, paddle sliders instead of knobs. They tried all this stuff before, and this was the last version of the TV Scoreboard before it was discontinued after the 1983 catalog. Also in 1983, the only year they offered the Tandyvision, which was simply an Intellivision with the word Tandyvision stuck on the box. It's really like the lamest rebranding attempt I've ever seen. They even directed you to Intellivision's cartridge hotline. They didn't even fix the most glaring flaw to a kid of this system. Despite the superior graphics and sound, those could not overcome the fact that it came with a game called Las Vegas Poker and Blackjack. I mean, who wants to play Las Vegas Poker and Blackjack?
I wonder why Radio Shack decided to sell the Tandyvision. Did they just buy like 1,000 televisions and replace their names?
Yeah, that's about all they did. So when you're playing Xbox with your friends, you're doing it usually on a TV, right?
Yes, and also on phones.
Yeah, well, this is a typical style TV game switch of the 70s and 80s era. It would be used for Atari and television or those kind of things. Much like a VCR, the TV scoreboard puts out a signal on a VHF channel. You connect it to the top with into one side of the switch and the antenna on the bottom. And note that the output has these lug wires, which would work great on an old TV. But, you know, eventually we switched from those to coax. So how am I going to connect it to this more modern coax connector on this flat panel TV here?
Doc, do you have a 75-ohm matching transformer?
You can use some little converters, but I happen to have this switch, which actually has both 75-ohm and 300-ohm connectors on it. So it is compatible with a flat screen, and I can just screw it right into the more modern TV. Here it is, just a very basic Pong-style game in black and white, and that's part of the reason this never got used is all my family and friends all had Ataris or Intellivisions, which had better sound and color, and you could buy new cartridges. You can see there, we've actually got it just stuck.
It happens all the time.
Yeah.
I think I like the Intellivision better.
Yeah. Let's take a look at Intellivision just real quick for comparison. So, look at that. You've got color, you've got better
this
sound.
Is my favorite game this on is, television.
This is Sea Battle. I used to spend a lot of time playing that. You know, you had a map, you laid out all your ships, and you can do all these battles. Ooh, I hit you.
How do I aim?
Hold down the aim button on the side, and you move the X, and then you fire.
How long could this last for?
This could last for a long time. This was one of my favorite games.
Oh no, we're in Battle Zone.
But anyway, so that's Intellivision. Let's get back to the electronic TV scoreboard and talk about the most unique feature, the light gun. You know, there's a lot of videos online about light guns. The key point about light guns to know is they don't work on flat panel modern LCD TVs. Like, as you can see here, the number on the left is the shots, the number on the right is scores, and I'm not scoring anything. So we had to go into our garage and get out the only CRT-based TV I have left, which is this old Admiral thing from the 60s. It was just covered in dust. I was afraid it's going to explode, but here goes.
And I got a fire extinguisher.
Yeah.
Mom, get ready to call 911.
Hang on, I don't see. Oh. The end result is it works on a CRT. It does work.
What's the other hand?
The score doesn't always come up. There we go. Now try to shoot it. Right. See, hit it. Oh, you lost two. The game itself is a little flaky. The score didn't show up unless I wiggled that knob at the top. I guess dirty contacts. But anyway, there you see the score. And
I'm rocking it.
Yes, you are. One funny thing about this is you can actually shoot the balls off the tennis court and stuff. The gun. If you plug in the gun controller, it's active all the time. That seems kind of silly. What do you think of this game versus your more modern game like your Bigfoot hunting game?
It's more realistic and it has scope view. And in the game, you're supposed to find some missing people and catch Bigfoot. Now today, you shoot something and you hit someone like in a first-person shooter game.
Yes. What I find interesting about this gun looks pretty realistic. You know, back then, the realism was in the hardware. You had a realistic-looking gun controlling a dot on the screen. But nowadays, you have just a generic mouse or something controlling a very realistic-looking gun, like this game. Gary's Mod.
Okay. We'll put those links in the description. And Bigfoot.
Okay. In closing, I wanted to take a look at the inside of this thing and see what's inside of it. Just curious, I guess. So there's two screws you have to take out. And inside, you'd find exactly what you expect. A circuit board. And there's the sockets for the gun and, you know, the speaker wires and all that stuff. And you've got the RF modulator there on the right. And there's a chip. And this particular chip is interesting because it's the AY38501, which is basically just all these video games on a chip. And it's apparently pretty historic and, according to Wikipedia, was used in many, many different types of consoles, of these Pong consoles, and later iterations of that chip were actually put onto cartridges and used in early cartridge systems. So it's kind of a cool piece of video game history, even though at the time I happened to use it, it was a little bit behind some of the games I already used. But that's about it. We just thank you for watching this video, and I guess it's about time we wrapped it up.
See you next time for another awesome video.
Oh.
Why are the knobs so terrible? Yay! I think we should show Komodo Gaming this.